I'm so caught up in this case. It's a complete nightmare. I found the body in the dumpster. I couldn't get the images out of my mind. I felt responsible for closing this case. The only witnesses? Complete loonies. That's when the situation began to get complicated.
Last night there was a murder here.
We found the victim's body in the dumpster out back. Did you happen to witness the murder?
Yeah, I think I did. Well, I was happily sewing in my happy little room, and I looked out my happy window, and I saw a not-so-happy man, and I felt sorry for him, so I followed him, and...
Yeah, the man was following
me. No, that's not how it happened! Be quiet! Okay, so... I followed the not-so-happy man to this room where he keeled over and died.
He was shot. Shot.
Shot.
He fainted.
Shot.
Fainted.
Shot.
Fainted.
He fell over onto the knife he had been carrying.
He was shot.
Be quiet. Anyway, he fell on his knife and blood spurted everywhere. But then the happy, smiley orderly took me back to my room, and he said to keep on smiling. And if I was good, I would never, ever have to leave Happy Hills. No, it's good!
Enough! Oh, I'm sorry, I'm Detective Riley.
Hi, I'm Amanda.
Do you know anything about the murder that happened last night?
Oh, I was walking on a path, and I heard a noise. So I went to go see what the noise was.
What do you think you heard?
Well, it sounded like I was walking on a...
Excuse me?
Hi, I'm Amanda.
Yeah, I already got that, but what did you hear?
I was walking on a path, and I heard a noise. It sounded like a... I was walking on a...
Excuse me?
Hi, I'm Amanda.
Okay, nice meeting you.
You're leaving already? Okay, bye!
Excuse me, sir. I'm Detective Riley. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Do you work for the government, Mr. Riley? Those dirty rats are poisoning our soil with their policies of corporate greed.
Do you know anything about the murder that occurred here last night?
Of course I do. You think I don't know what's going on around here? I don't belong in this place. I'm the only sane one living here.
I see. Now, what can you tell me about the murder?
I can tell you, but not here. You're listening.
Where were you on the night of the murder?
Same place I always am, in the kitchen. It's the only place with a vent. You gotta get fresh air somehow. They're gassing us, you know. I was standing in the kitchen when I heard the voices. I went to the window and you will never guess who I saw. It was Nixon. Nixon talking to Elvis, of all people. I knew he was still alive. They were discussing building landing strips for Martians. And God knows what else. I was distracted by two men. At first I didn't notice anything unusual. There are always suspicious people walking across these lawns. But then I noticed that they were carrying a coffin. A wooden coffin. With the corpse of Bigfoot!
Okay. I think I've heard enough. Here's my card. If anything comes up, give me a call.
Do you know where AIDS originated, Mr. Riley? Do you?!
They said I was insane. that the murder never happened. And I was a patient there. The case was unsolved. Indefinitely.